Hey, thanks for stopping by. In this episode of my Roblox Advanced Scripting tutorial series, I'm going to be discussing about delete instances, what they are, how they are used, and why you should use them. Delete instances is a term that I kind of made up because it reflects on ways that Roblox has provided us tools to handle unnecessary or unneeded objects or instances that we just have lying around inside of our Roblox games that we create. And in this guide, I'm going to show you different ways of how Roblox has provided us these tools to help us with those situations. But in order to understand what I'm talking about, let me show you an example. All right, let's think about this for a minute. So I just quickly created something that I think will be a great example for what I'm about to show you in this episode. So right in front of me, I have a coin spawning pad that randomly spawns coins onto this pad, and then after a certain period of time, which is about 5 seconds, they end up disappearing. The reason I have it do this is because my initial intention was that when a player steps on one of these coins, then they will add a point to their leader stat, but I did not create that yet. And so what's really important to note here is that these coins, when they're not being picked up, they despawn on their own after 5 seconds. It doesn't have to rely on me to pick them up before they actually despawn, because if I just come over here and pick up one of these coins, they disappear like intended. We don't have to deal with them anymore. Once they're collected, we just wait for the next one to spawn in. And so Roblox has provided us 3 methods to deal with deleting instances, and I'm going to be showing you how to do all 3 of them in this episode. All right, like I mentioned with my example, we don't want to keep these parts lying around inside of the game that we don't need anymore, otherwise it'll slow down Roblox, and we have to have a healthy amount of garbage collection when it comes to handling what parts we don't need and what parts we should keep in the world. So there's something I want you to understand. In our Explorer, we have all of these instances and parts. They all have a parent that is basically like the folder that the object or part or whatever it is contained inside. So if we look at our base plate, our base plate's parent, our parent property here, is workspace, which is basically the folder of base plate. Base plate is a child, also known as like a file inside of a folder, inside of workspace. That also applies to everything else that's here inside the workspace. You have the camera, terrain, spawn location, and let's say I were to insert a new part. So if I go to model up here and then click on part, I inserted a new part into the workspace. But if I go over here to the right and click on part in the Explorer, we can see that the parent is also inside of the workspace. And so that's something I want you to keep aware of when I'm going to be discussing about remove and how this affects parts inside of the game. So now that we have this part, how do we want to remove it through script? Well, the first thing we're going to do is obviously create a script. And on the right side, let's create a script that'll be parented to part. So we will click the plus sign that's in part, and then we will say script. So now, as we can see here with the script, the parent property of the script is the part itself. So we want to be able to locate that part. And we're gonna do this by first deleting this, and then we'll make reference to that part by saying local part equals script.parent. So we've made reference to the part that's basically located on the script's parent. And I'll simply show you the first method. But before we do that, let's actually create a wait at the very beginning of the script so that we can see the change happening when we delete it. So we're going to say task.wait, and then inside of these parentheses, we're going to put a number indicating the number of seconds we're going to wait until we execute this script. So we'll say 6. And then down here, let's say part colon remove. And then we will wrap these around in open and close parentheses. So let's go into the game. Let's hit test and hit play so that we can actually see the change that happens. And so let me open the Explorer really quick so we can really see the change. So after about 6 seconds, as you can see, the part disappeared not only in the workspace, but also in the Explorer. So that pretty much did what we intended it to do. So what's the issue here? There's a lot of intricate stuff that goes on in the back of Roblox's servers and game management, stuff like that, that it's kind of a bit complicated, but effectively what this did was that it took the part's parent over here. If I go into the Explorer, click on part, and then see its parent, this effectively set the parent of the part to nil. And as you know, nil is a none value. It's a value that does not exist. So now that we know that remove basically sets the parent of the part to null, it's sort of just floating around in the game's content. But now the game doesn't know what to do with it because there is no parent set to it. So it didn't fully get rid of it. So Roblox has provided a better alternative called destroy. So if we go into our script and replace remove with destroy instead, we can actually see that it does multiple things. It not only sets the parent property to nil like remove does, but it also locks the parent of the instance and it disconnects all connections and calls destroy on all children. So it basically does what remove does, but as an added layer of security, it does all these other things in order to provide as much performance as the game can give you when you get rid of a part. So all in all, this is just a much better method to use over remove. So I mentioned in my example in the beginning of this tutorial that I basically had coins that came into the game, and then after a certain period of time, I made them disappear. That actually didn't have to do with putting in a wait statement before destroying it. There's actually a much better way of dealing with that sort of stuff to know after a certain amount of time to just delete the instance whenever I needed to without using a wait statement. And I'll show you two ways of doing this and why I recommend this third method rather than using a wait statement. So this third method is called debris. And this is basically a model that Roblox has provided where it handles garbage collection when you want to delete a part within a specific amount of time, rather than having to delete the part through one single command. So if we go back up here to our script, we can see that we have our wait statement here in the very first line before actually destroying the part. I actually would not advise doing this by using a wait statement and then destroying the part. I will explain to you why in just a little bit. So let's delete this first line up here with the wait statement. And let's also just comment out this part really quick by putting in the two dashes in front of the command. So let's hit enter down here and let's type in game.debris because this is the framework that we're going to be using in order to handle garbage collection. And we're going to say colon add item. In the first argument, we're going to throw in the part, and then we're going to separate using a comma for our second argument, and we're going to give a number. So we used the number 6 for the time we wanted to use for when the part was actually going to be destroyed. So this is how we're going to do it. Instead of using task.wait 6 seconds and then destroying the part, we're simply doing this in one line by saying game.debris, and then this is the method we're using, add item. We want to add this part to the debris garbage collection after 6 seconds that this line has been executed. So if we go back into the game and then hit play, we should pretty much see the same exact result, just using a different framework. So in about 6 seconds, the part should be removed. If we look at our Explorer, then the part is definitely not there in the Explorer anymore. So that effectively did the exact same thing as destroy, but we gave it a certain time before it actually deleted itself. Now it's time to answer the question, why should we use debris over using a wait statement and then destroying the part? Okay, so going back to my coins example, here's the script right here. The only thing you really need to know about is the delete instance part, where I basically have a wait statement here that waits 5 seconds, and then it destroys the part. This is not a good idea. Let's see what happens when we actually do decide to have a wait statement and then destroy it. When you saw my original example, every single second there was a new coin that was spawning in, and then it was going to delete itself after 5 seconds. It wasn't dependent on any other coin that was inside of the spawn location before it deleted itself. But now it seems like when I added a wait statement, it seems to wait for the coin to disappear first before spawning in another one. This is clearly not what we want, and the reason I can explain why this is happening is because effectively when we spawn in a coin using calling this function here in our while true do statement, it creates a new coin. It sets that new coin's parent to workspace, and then it's going to wait 5 seconds before destroying this new coin. But what you don't realize is happening is that this function is being called, and we've added in a wait statement here where we're literally telling the script to stop what it's doing for 5 seconds and then destroy the new coin before ending the function and then jumping back down to here to start the script all over again. The reason this is ineffective is because we're actually telling the script to wait 6 seconds instead of one before spawning in another coin. So 5 seconds here for it to be destroyed, and then another second here in order to spawn the coin again. When in actuality, we want the loop to go every second rather than every 6 seconds. And so when we use debris, it's actually not dependent on the previous coin before it spawns in the next one. So if I go back to the script and quickly comment these two points out and then uncomment the new one, game.debris add item new coin 5 seconds, we will see that it's not dependent on the previous coin before spawning in the next one. So instead of waiting 6 seconds, so waiting 5 seconds for the first one to despawn and then wait another second to spawn in the next one, it just simply waits 1 second before spawning in the next one, and then independently, each coin will despawn after 5 seconds. That's why I think using add item for game.debris is a better method of when you want to get rid of an item after a specific number of time. So in summary, remove basically just sets the parent of whatever instance you're trying to get rid of to nil. And I'm just gonna say, do not use remove. It is not a very effective strategy to get rid of stuff, but it's still great to understand how this stuff works. Destroy gets rid of whatever instance you're trying to get rid of in the most optimal way possible. And you should only use this if you want to immediately get rid of an object without having to wait for it. And then debris should be used when you want to get rid of an instance after a set amount of time that you give it. It's important to know when to use debris and when to use destroy. I hope you found this episode to be helpful. Be sure to check out my other videos on my advanced scripting tutorial series, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.